In the dead of the night, liberal Democrats in Washington, D.C. rammed a government takeover of health care through the Congress, filled with individual mandates, job-killing taxes, and government-run insurance. Some say we made history. I say we broke history as we turned our back on our finest traditions of limited government, personal responsibility, and the consent of the governed. We can reform health care without putting our country on a pathway towards socialized medicine, and Republicans are committed to that cause. Throughout the past year, House Republicans have steadfastly advocated ways to fix this country's health care system by reducing costs, specifically through instituting tort reform and allowing Americans to purchase health insurance across state lines. As Washington Democrats embark on their attempt to sell government-run insurance across this country, I think they're in for a rude awakening. A few more speeches about the same bad law will not change any minds in America. The American people don't want a government takeover of health care, and House Republicans will work every day to repeal this law and start over. With the support of a bipartisan opposition on Capitol Hill, this law will not stand. If we repeal Obamacare with its job-killing taxes and mandates, we can start over with common-sense market solutions that lower the cost of health insurance with more choices, not more government. If we repeal Obamacare, we can end the era of defensive medicine and pass real malpractice reforms and use those savings to fund state programs that provide insurance for Americans with pre-existing conditions. And if we repeal Obamacare and start over, we can renew our commitment to seniors in Medicare and pursue the kind of reform required to achieve long-term solvency in the program. And lastly, if we repeal Obamacare and start over, we can restore the historic prohibition on public funding of elective abortions. House Democrats were wrong to exchange 30 years of pro-life statutory protections for a piece of paper signed by the most pro-abortion president in American history. The enactment of Obamacare was a blow to our freedom that can either discourage us to the point of retreat or motivate us to greater action. Victory may not be ours today, but there will be another day. House Republicans are committed to repeal Obamacare and start over with reforms that reflect the common sense and common values of the American people.